Day showed me, who has been very, very friendly to Fika, very, very, he listens to us, he's open to us, he discusses freely with us. You would have thought that he has known Fika for a very long time. So I want to say thank you very much, sir. We are very, very grateful for your support and contribution to Fika. I want to acknowledge our students, not particularly because they are the ones that built the website, but because of the attitude they brought to the job. They were very accommodative, very patient. It is a capacity building platform. We are hoping that along the line, in the course of time, our members will take advantage of it. The industry also will take advantage of it. Not only to just disseminate information, but also build competence among the financial journalists.
We are happy to say that this is a website that was built by our students under a strict supervision of our in-house technical team. Vastnet Technologies Limited is a leading developer for consumer and enterprise mobile value-added services. As an ICT company located in Nigeria and outside Nigeria, with extensive expertise in the development and delivery of mobile value-added services to telecom operators, we are happy to celebrate with you and everyone seated here on this success of this launch of our website.
So we have the website. If we cannot get it to work, it's a waste of time, it's a waste of money. So what do we want to achieve? Now, as far as most people are concerned, we are in a terrible situation in Nigeria. And compared to what we've known over the last 15 years, up until about a year or so ago, it looks as if we've gone from pain to pain to pain. And it is true. Everybody is feeling it one way. Those used to drink champagne for breakfast, maybe now having to do it twice a week. That's their own pain. But there are a lot of other people who to even feel it's a bigger pain. But what we're beginning to see is that people are looking inwards and finding opportunities within Nigeria, because it doesn't make sense do some things outside Nigeria. And because we're looking more and more inwards, the ability to get information on news on what is happening locally is also constrained. And it's an irony when people say, have you looked at CNN, what they're saying about Nigeria, breaking news, and it happens with people who are outside Nigeria. I say for the financial space, it should not be the case. You need to be the reference point that people are always quoting. That whatever is happening in Nigeria, and the real issue everybody reports or complains about is financial in nature, exchange rate, interest rate, their spending or not spending. You have to be. And one of the ways you will communicate with the world is with a website. The new generation that are up and coming will not buy newspapers, not the way we know it, because they did not grow up in their formative years picking papers. But they still read. They read with apps, with going to websites, they communicate with WhatsApp and what have you. You don't move to that media, you don't move to that realm, you will go the way of the dinosaur. So for me, this is the beginning. And what we make of it is going to impact on us and our profession in Nigeria. So building the website was one, but we need to keep it running.
I want to congratulate you, and particularly to congratulate the current executive of FICAN. There's been so many achievements. Of course, the secretariat is one, the website, the publication. I can't name all the achievements of the current executive.